Okay, I'm not too sure if I really need this mic. Let's go with that.
Can you guys hear me fine without it?
Yeah.
Yeah? Good? So, you're welcome to use the mic.
Okay.
So, it's 5 minutes after six, so I'm going to go ahead and get started. We might have a few that trickle in. My name is Troy Price. I serve as the Executive Director for the Snow Basin Sports Education Foundation and have all the way since July 1st. Right? So, new to the position, not new to ski racing and not new to the community. This is year 26 in ski racing and youth sport. And it was my pleasure to serve as the program director for the Snow Basin Ski Team between the years of 2004 and 2010 before I accepted the position as program director for the Romar Ski Academy in Salt Lake. Been down there the last 13 years and I'm really excited to be back, part of the community and the potential of the Snow Basin Resort. Snow Basin Ski have in this community is extremely inviting to me individually. Excited as an alum of the program. I grew up ski racing for Snow Basin Ski Team. And my dad was a ski patrol as a youth, mom was a ski instructor. And so Snow Basin has always been home to me. And so it's with great pride that I come back into the community and bring my experience in running programs to elevate what's already a successful program. It's extremely happy for me to have such a wonderful support staff with Winter as our new program director for the freeride team. Big round of applause for Winter. We've learned a lot from Winter this evening, but I also want to recognize that part of my vision is to make sure that all three departments within our organization start to come together and share a vision on how athletes and students progress through our pipeline to make sure they truly fall in love with the sport of skiing and that we meet their desire with the right programming professionalism. And so also with us this evening is Craig Hosser, our Alpine Program Director. TJ is our Evo Team Manager. So all three departments with our organization are represented and then they all have oversight by our wonderful team admin, Tracy Crew back there. Staff here in a second, but it's great to see so much retention within our staff, and I couldn't be more pleased with the way that Winter has stepped up to that role of program director. She's truly admired amongst our freeride community. I've talked with my friends in Jackson and Snowbird and Bogus. They all can speak very highly of Winter, and so I'm really happy to rally behind her, give her the support that she needs to be successful in her first year as program director. I'm very confident that we can create that culture and programming to where all the athletes really truly enjoy waking up in the morning, get prepared and are safe and progressing their skill set while they're out on the hill. So again, big round of applause for women. true priorities are as an organization. And then Winter will dive in and really cover the free ride program, going through what you should expect on a day-to-day situation, give you a little preview into the world of competition. I know some of you have a lot of experience there and some are new. I am 100% new, so I'm just like this huge sponge trying to absorb all this information myself. And then use my knowledge and expertise over the last 26 years to hopefully help shape not only the Snow Basin Free Ride Program, but IFSA as a whole. And so that's a national organization that we can really provide for athlete success. Okay, so Winter, if you would please. Just starting with our mission statement. It's rather simple. We're here to create an environment and a pathway for our local youth to be able to reach their individual potential as athletes, students, and contributing members of the greater community through the use of winter sports. For me, there's obviously a few key words in there. It's students, and we do care about academics. Coaches have a huge impact on keeping that whole athlete development, holding athletes accountable for what's going on in school. And so as parents, recognize that coaches are part of your support system around your child. And then the last part of that, a greater community, is I really want to make sure that we're developing responsible, respectful individuals represent our program and our resort and our greater community to the best extent possible. I think to summarize that for me, if I will, like an elevator speech, is that we use the excuse of skiing to develop good humans. Next. Our team values. This was something I created with the support of our staff and then introduced the athletes at our orientation campout, which some of the athletes here were the part of. The athletes got a chance to vote, and so we modified those team values based off of some athlete input, and then went to our board of directors, got a few more input there, and then ratified our plan so that we can really base every day that we operate as a program off these team values of relationships, commitment, integrity, performance, team pride, and growth mindset. With relationships, That's a big topic, right? But for an athlete, it truly means friendships. That they're being respectful of their fellow teammates and developing friends for life. Some of my very best friends today are kids that grew up skiing for Jackson Hole and Snowbird. And a couple of them have reunited, or they went to school at Weber State and ended up living in Auckland for the last 20 years. And because of the experience we have when we were 10, 11, 12 years old, we're raising our families together, even though they grew up in Jackson and Stoneville. So, but then as parents and coaches and admin, relationships takes on a whole new meaning. It's being ambassadors of the sport. It's representing our sponsors and developing those relationships, making sure that we're very respectful of the resort and what they provide for us with discounts and terrain space and holding comps and all that things that we couldn't do it at all without the support of Snow Basin Resort, right? Like, we can't have a Snow Basin ski team at the local park. And so that relationship with the resort is paramount to our success. Commitment, we're looking to create an athlete pipeline so that athletes can spend more time and energy into the sport and that they're really feeling that self-pride and growth internally by committing more time and effort into their sports. Integrity speaks for itself. We want athletes to, you know, do the right thing for the right reasons at the right time, and even without any prodding or supervision of coaches and parents. We want to develop athletes that can decide right from wrong and do the right thing. For performance, we are an athletic program, so we're going to hit some benchmarks and targets on where we want to be as a program and what we want to accomplish. And then team pride. The way that we summarize this one is that it's celebrating and finding the joy within today's program, but celebrating our past, connecting with our alumni, and then planning for our future, making sure that all the kids in the program are also mentors and have some ties with the program as they become alumni and come back and give back. We have a lot of alumni that are our coaches, but we also have a lot of alumni that are sponsors and donors to the program, and that longevity is important. Growth mindset speaks for itself. We want to make sure that our athletes are persevering even during challenging times. They recognize that failure is a step of growth. And we put ourselves in situations, especially with the free ride program, that we're out there in really tough conditions and we're finding ways to be successful. We're looking at those controllable items. What can we do as individuals? What can we do as a team to be successful in those challenging situations? Okay. Team culture, I won't dive on this one too much, but it's in the blue there, kindness, perseverance, and commitment. Covered a lot of that already, but none of this happens without the support of everybody involved in our program. So when I say everybody, I'm talking all the coaching staff, obviously, but you as parents, all of our athletes, the donors, everybody that's involved with our program starts to embrace this culture that we, as an entire community, can stop that snowball fight from happening or that wrestling match from fighting. Because we believe in a culture of kindness and respect, even though that it's part of growing up. But is that the right thing to do in this right environment? And so empowering everybody to make a common collective good on how we act and how we persevere, our commitment to one another, and then we're striving for a championship mindset for all the athletes. Okay. Respect. Big word, easy to understand, but it starts with respecting yourself, looking at even that 10-year-old athlete, looking at themselves as an ambassador of the resort. They put on the team jacket with pride. They're respecting their coaches by listening and following instructions. And then their peers, you know, really looking for that mentor to help guide. There's a lot of older athletes in our free ride program that can be great mentors. Respecting the mountain, this isn't necessarily the rules of the mountain, but just the environment, right? So there's avalanche training, a little tough place with it, having the right equipment, knowing the zone that you're in, and then in particular, like closed areas and the directions again from the coaches and the safety priority. And then respecting your equipment, making sure that your skis or bindings are in particular are mounted correctly so that you're confident in your equipment as you're putting yourself in that high-risk environment. That they're tuned and boots are fitting properly, all that good stuff. So your personal equipment should be respected and ready for top-level performance at all times. Next couple slides are about expectations. Starting with young athletes, we want them to be on time, listen to coaches, set personal goals, always exhibit that teamwork and sportsmanship. I really, really enjoy, you know, part of my experience, I serve as the development director for Intermountain Division on the Alpine side and have for the last 15 years or so. But one of the things that brings me personal joy is watching the Snow Basin athletes with the Jackson Hole athletes, with the Bogus Basin athletes, and really start to hang out at the start of comps or races and develop friendships. You start to see that they're following each other on social media. They're networking as a group. And I've had the pleasure of running camps to where athletes will stay for 3 or 4 days and their roommate is from a different team. So then they really accelerate that pathway of developing friendships. And so it's really fun to watch that happen. And especially when you see it 5, 10 years down the road that they're going to a championship together. They've made some elite camp that they're going to together with friends because of a camp that they did when they were 11 years old. And then probably most importantly is that they're having fun all the way through. There's a lot of studies in youth sport that the reason why kids quit is they're not having fun. So there's lots of ways for us as coaches to create that fun environment. That still is safe, that still progresses their skills, that still is respectful of one another. Like, fun can be in a lot of different aspects, but we have to create that fun environment to keep them intrigued and committed to the sport. And then on the other side of the screen there, you can see that it's showing respect and kindness. I think we covered that. The resort policies, taking self-responsibility. This really relates back to that behavior. I want to develop athletes that are accountable for their actions. and that when we get to that point, if ever a disciplinary action, that they can take that ownership of what took place, be honest with their coach, and be part of that long-term solution. And then ultimately recognizing that membership within the program is a privilege and could be pulled if they're not being kind, not being respectful. So a lot of these things we've talked about, if there's constant problems, there's that cancerous situation in our program, we will remove that member. Okay? You have my word on that. Hopefully that's not you. But I'm also trying to protect you, protect what we have as a program. And so we're not going to get to that point where we're just all-inclusive all the time, even if they're not following our honor codes and our team priorities. We have to stress that we need people to come together under that umbrella of team priorities. For the staff, starts with me, but then also with Winter and our head coaches, is that they lead by example, they're professional, they're creating that safe learning environment, that they communicate back to you as parents in a timely manner, and that they're always mindful of our partnerships within our community. First and foremost, again, is that partnership that we have with School Based Resort. Okay. For you as parents, it's making sure that your love is unconditional, regardless of their performance at a comp. A lot of times, there's so much anxiety as a parent, that you're standing there all day and then something happens, and again, I'm brand new to the free ride world, but I can only imagine because it's judged and subjective. It's like there's gonna be tons of opinions on, like, I saw this kid did that, but yet their scores are totally different. So we just have to keep that long-term vision in mind. You know, what is it about? What is our team about? It's about creating those good humans in the community, developing that passion for the sport, and that longevity so that they can develop lifelong skills. Also, part of the expectation for you as a parent is that when we reach out to you for communication, you're quick to respond back. There's a lot of the planning that Winter will go through, that, you know, whether it's a Christmas camp activity or this came up, we need release forms for this venue, like, we need that response in a very timely manner so that we can continue to look professional with our business partners out there and have everything that we need to plan an efficient training session or that comp coming up, all those things make place. And then also you as parents have that responsibility of being mindful to our partnerships within the community. You know, you look at the last slide where to celebrate the sponsors that we have, and you have a chance to go to those places of business and support them as an individual and tell them thanks because you're benefiting from their donation as part of our team. Right? And then this is the last slide for me, but it's just the contact information. You find all this on our website. But I want to recognize also Coach Adam. He's stepped up to be our intro to freeride coach. There's been a little bit of a name change there. It was the development freeride, the freeride development team. And it was getting confused with the Devo program. By show of hands, who came through the Devo program? Love that. Okay. That's really part of the vision, is to create that culture within our Devo program that's establishing the skill set and pushing kids up in the either the offline or the freeride program, wherever the family and the athlete has interest to explore. That's great. I'm going to turn it over to Winter. Before I do, if you guys would be helpful for me, if you just introduce yourself and how long you've been with the program and who your athlete is.
Try really quick. Can we hear Coach Interest? Winter, which you have still been. Real quick, I'm Winter. Before I introduce politely, thank you for that. These are some of our free ride coaches. I think your oldest dude is quick because Richard has to leave. But Richard, Ethan, Chase, Kev, tell everybody a little about yourself.
I'm Richard. This is my fifth year as an instructor. I've been and so many new athletes. It was awesome to meet all those new kids and see how they did throughout the season and all the new check boxes they cleared off their list. So looking forward to some more of that this year.
My name's Chase. I'm kind of a legacy kid for the team. So Troy's actually my coach back from 2000 to 2004. The mountain always tends to bring us all back together, so this will be my second year coaching through Red, Pesto Basin, but I've also been coaching at Woodward as well, so hopefully we'll get to do a bunch of trampoline and foam pit practice with you guys. Awesome.
Sweet. I'm Kev. I've been with the program for years, coaching for 8 now. Super stoked to be with the program again, lots of new coaches as well with us. Proud accomplishment. I just happened to get on Team USA's rugby referee squad, so I'll be treating your kids like a rugby team as well.
Outside of the sport, we also have Adam, who unfortunately wasn't able to make it this year. Like Troy said, he stepped up as our interim free ride head coach, which is awesome. And then our new coach, Juliana Dresnick, she is an excellent free ride skier. She qualified fourth in North and South America on the free ride world qualifier circuit. So she's a super awesome skier. She's coached at Jackson. Athlete team last year, and it's really accomplished as a skier. We're happy to have her join our team. Harrison, who's also not here, second year with us. He is a pretty big mountain biker, competes in mountain biking in the summer and in Peru events. And then Parker, who's our director last year, was on the ski team with Chase, yeah? So, around 2000. Hi, guys. And then Libby, who's going to be subbing in for us here and there. So, she's coached this for 3 years now with the race team and the air raid team. Also, want to know about the avalanche education on the avalanche.
No, I'll introduce myself.
Okay.
I'm Miles, and I'm a free rider.
I'm Kaylee. My son's done a couple years with Evo, and he's starting to free ride this year.
I am Amber. So I have a 13-year-old Hudson. This is his third year on free ride. And then my 12-year-old is starting free ride this year.
I'm Sarah, and I have a son, Emerson, who's 10, and we're new this year to the free ride team.
Hi, my name is Lisa Bodley. My daddy is principal this month, or next month, and we've done Evo Plus for the last couple years, and we're excited to do intro to free ride.
My name is Lynn, and my sons are Milo and Leo, and this is Milo's third year and Leo's second year.
Hi, my name is Chris. I have one son in Evo, Henry, and my oldest, Owen, is in the free ride team. So it's our third year. We started Evo, and it was run by Snow Basin, and now we're over here.
My name is Jerry, I like long rocks in the rain. Sorry, just announced who I am to my child. I walked in late, sorry.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so my daughter is Jane. She did Evo last year and she's doing free ride this year. Our older kids did it as well, and so she had to do it because they did it and she loved it. So.
My name's Nikki. I have two sons, Luca and Vinny, and Luca did Evo Mini. And he'll do Evo this year. And then Vinny did Evo Mini, Evo, and now he wants to try free ride. And Emerson is his friend, so they're doing it together, Sarah said. And we're like anxious moms about it, so we want to know a little bit more about it.
You're in the right spot.
Okay.
Hi, I'm Eric, and my son Oliver did Evo last year, and I was super excited to get him in the free ride program. He's 8 years old, and super stoked.
Hi, I'm Chris, and this is Jose. Let's see, we have Daisy on the free ride team. She's just turned 10, so she did it last year for the first time. Super stoked about it. She's got a lot of goals. And then we've got a 7-year-old that's on Devo, and then our littlest is going to be on Devo Mini. And this guy next to me was rookie coach last year with the Devo program, so we're kind of committed to this whole thing, and yeah, he got rookie of the year or two for coaching, so this is kind of our community, so we're happy to be here and to see where our kids go.
Hi, I'm Jen Christensen. This is Jared Christensen, and Matt did Devos last year with Richard. Richard was his coach, and he loved him. So anyway, he's going to do intro to free ride this year, and this is Ace, and this is his first year on mini Devos.
I'm Skyler, and my son Cyrus, and he's 8, first year in free ride intro, and he's really excited as well, so happy to be here.
I'm Katie, and my son Max did free ride last year for the first time. And then we're going to have a daughter who's an alpine racer is going to come out for a few days of free ride this year.
You guys, I know that's a little awkward, but it was super helpful for me. And hopefully you saw some value in it for yourself too. There's lots of you that are new to the free ride world. But we're part of the Devo program, and so you may feel like a little anxiety on what this is all about. So you're in the right place, but please know that you're surrounded by a ton of others that are in the exact same situation. So as we come together as a community, you guys can lean on each other, but we've got a tremendous coaching staff, really excited for the year ahead. So I'll turn it over to Wayne.
first things first is the free ride handbook. So if you have an iPhone, this is a good time to take it out, take a picture, so you can have this on your phone to read later. This is something I put together last year, but it pretty much has all program information that you'll need. So if you have questions over the next month or so, read through this, it might answer some of those for you. It kind of goes over what we do day to day, competition info, all of that. It also has contact information, so my phone number, Adam's phone number, Troy, Tracy. If you need me urgently, you can call me. I will not answer the phone after 8 p.m. Just heads up. So call me before 8. And then email if it's not urgent. I will get to my emails a few times a week.
The handbook lives on our website.
Oh yeah, you can find it on the free ride page on our website. There's a big button at the top that says free ride handbook if you ever need access to it. So far we have 21 competition athletes, 36 intro free ride athletes, and 10 halfway add-ons. So we're looking at 67, if I am doing my math right. On the next slide, there's another QR code, so take your phone out again. This is going to be super helpful for me to know a little bit more about your athletes, to know what days they're training, so I can have appropriate staffing for that day, specifically on the weekends. If you're a one-day program, you can specify Saturday or Sunday, and then I'll make sure that we have appropriate staffing for those days. That is the same one. So I did send this out in Team Snap already. Some of you have filled it out, but about half of you have not. So if you haven't, again, something you can do afterwards, it'll just help me a ton. There's also a question about our Colorado camp this fall at the beginning of November. We are doing a free ride camp for that. It's not just Alpine. So if you need more information about that, you can ask me or Troy and we'll get that for you. Coaches, again, you went over that. This is something that Troy showed me, actually, but kind of just long-term athletic development. I really liked it. Having an active start at a young age, this is like Diva Mini or even before that. With intro to free ride, we're training to train and learning to train for some of us. And then once you move into the competition free ride team, you're training to compete and then training to win competitive for life. And as you age up into your late teens and early adulthood, fit for life, and then hopefully active for life. Our big goal is to create good humans, like Troy said. So that also includes prioritizing health and making sure we're taking care of ourselves the best we can. The Free Ride Coaching Foundations that we focus on are the IFSA judging categories for competitions. I really like these as our coaching foundation just because it's everything that you need to know for skiing. Technique, this is edging, upper lower body separation, parallel turns, that sort of thing. Control, always wanting to be in control. Line choice, this is navigating your way down the mountain, knowing where you're going, looking ahead, picking features that are within abilities, whether it be cliffs, chutes, or even just an open slope. Fluidity, learning to move fluidly down the mountain. And then style and energy, this is where most kids get really excited, learning 180s and 360s, doing cliffs, but also just being comfortable on your skis is huge. So we're teaching all of these things to your athletes to hopefully build them into other skiers and other athletes. So right now we are in our conditioning period. So we're doing dry land at the park Tuesdays and Thursdays in Ogden. We have our fall camps in Loveland. Oh, we also have ice skating on Sundays. I think some of you have been coming. If you would like to join us, information is on Team Snap in our summer 2023 page. If you have questions about it, let me know. I'm happy to help give any information you need. Then we're going to move into our prep period once we get on snow in December. Hopefully, we get enough snow. It's looking hopeful. So. Doing directed drills, skills development, with some mental skills training as well. And then moving into our competition phase for our competition athletes, which is starting at the beginning of January, early February. And then we're focusing again on ongoing skills development and mental skills training for competition. And then we'll move into summer. It's kind of our off season. A lot of you guys are doing other sports, but we'll have some summer camps that we're for sure going to Mammoth this year, so put that in your calendar. We'll have a free ride group going as well with a few free ride coaches. It'll be really, really fun. So hopefully some of you guys can make it. Tentatively there too. I'm working on getting us at Woodward for training once or twice a month right now. That'll start for sure by winter. And then tentative UOP training on the water ramps in the fall. So just some stuff to look forward to and kind of our seasonal progression. So our daily schedule, we're going to meet. Oh, go ahead.
What is UOP? I'm sorry if I'm being, oh, doesn't know what that is, but what is UOP?
It's the Utah Olympic Park up in Park City. So they have some water ramps that...
I've seen those ramps.
Yeah.
I just wanted to make sure.
It's super fun. Kids learn how to do backflips on trampolines or 360s, or 7s, that sort of thing, and they can take it to the water ramp and... just kind of like a nice progression before trying to move on the snow. Our daily schedule, we're going to meet at 8:30, warm up at the base here by Don Paul. We were meeting at 8:45 last season, and that's a little earlier, but we're hoping that we can get warmed up by 8:45, 8:50, and then be in line before 9 so we can get skiing as soon as possible. I know that is a little earlier, but it's also getting busier at Snow Basin, so you guys are going to want to leave earlier to get there anyway. So, focus on punctuality this year. Did you all a little more kind of than last year? Load lifts at 9, do our morning session. Lunch, I do want to note that your athlete needs to bring lunch or have money for lunch. If you're moving from Devo, I know that's a little different, but moving into the free ride team, there's a level of maturity that we expect with those athletes. So if you have any concerns with this, let me know, but I'm sure your athlete has lunch or lunch money. And most of those guys will go eat together at the yurt or at the John Paul or in Eagles Lodge. And then it's their responsibility. Their coach will tell them what time to meet back at the yurt or back at the base area. And then they'll go from there, but it's their responsibility to be on time after lunch. Go ahead.
So if we send lunch, are they supposed to carry that in the backpack all day? Or
no, they can put it in the base here by John Paul.
Oh, is that what you just told?
Yes. Yeah. Yep. Okay. Any other questions about that? I would recommend snacks in pockets. You guys can send us like a granola bar or something. That helps us coaches if we get angry kiddos. After lunch, we'll do our afternoon session, finish at 3, and then do a quick recap and meet you guys here. Again, we're expecting a level of maturity from athletes, so if they need to meet you elsewhere at Wildcat Lodge or at your car, then we can arrange that. Our midweek training will be at 12:30, and then run through our afternoon session and be done at 4. And then same thing, we can meet you at the base here, or we can plan for a different meeting location.
So for the Friday afternoon, is that the schedule?
Yes. Any other questions about this? I really like this diagram to show kind of what my coaching priority is and what I encourage our other coaches to use. So on the left is performance, and then on the bottom is level of stress. You can also see that as like difficulty of terrain also. So as terrain, or not necessarily terrain all the time, but just whatever situation an athlete's in, if it's too easy, they're bored, they don't care, they lose interest, and that's that left side of In this middle, this is what we're focusing on. So we're challenging them just enough so they're stepping outside of their comfort zone a little, but not too far, where you get into this choke and burnout. This is sometimes where there's tears or panic and we don't want to get there. This is especially important for free ride, where we're assessing and looking at features, cliffs, chutes that might scare athletes, and we're always encouraging to find the right terrain for them and then go from there. I just like this. I think it explains what we're trying to do. So we're getting high performance, we're not scared, we're not bored, we're having fun. Any questions on that? This is something that Troy also showed me, but it's just about messaging. We're always shooting for the right message at the right time so that our athletes and coaches are successful. The wrong message at the wrong time can be disastrous sometimes. Again, tears, fear, choke. Competitions. So if you are planning to compete, this is important to note. I have to say it can be very confusing, and I understand that. I'm here to help you guys. They're making changes this year that we're all going to have to navigate together. So we'll learn about those over the next couple months. They're meeting at the end of this month to go over how they're going to approach those changes, and then we'll learn about them in November. So just be ready for that. There's going to be a little bit of difference in competition season from last year. As far as regional, national, our first year athletes and sometimes second and third year athletes are going to be regional competitors. And then athletes that qualify or are at kind of like a higher competition level are those national athletes. To go back to regional, we're shooting those for all athletes, competing up to 5 events, and then only 3 nationals. So far, they've only published 2 national events in our region, in a mountain. So that's Utah and Idaho. So we're gonna shoot for Snowbird and Targhee, and then hopefully they'll come up with another one elsewhere. Not sure where that'll be. We may have to travel a little further for that. But that's also up to 5 regional events. So Solitude, Snow Basin, Snowbird, Park City, Bogus Basin, Tamarack. There's another slide with all these. You guys can take a photo of it. But it starts as open registration. So this is first come, first serve. It's very important that you guys purchase your membership beforehand. And then you're on the computer, logged in, ready to sign up at registration opening. It's very competitive. It's hard to get in sometimes. That's another reason they're recommending up to 5. Once you get 3 really good finishes, probably don't do your other 2 competitions so that we can get other Intermountain athletes the finishes that they need. And then also write down the passwords and your username for your IFSA in case you need it for registration. Just have that on hand. For 12 to 14 athletes that are coming up from the 12s, your first 2 of 3, or your best 2 of 3 scores of your first 3 events will count for their overall ranking moving forward. I think rankings are going to get more important with those changes that are happening over the next month or 2. Go ahead. The intro to no, unless you would like to try 1 competition or 2 competitions, and then you'll need to get a membership and that sort of thing. But mostly for this competition athletes. If you're not planning to compete, then don't need to worry about it yet. Okay, for the national events, you're going to start, pre-qualified athletes are going to have priority to get into those events. These are way more competitive than regional events even. And then quota spots, so depending on how many athletes you have on your team, I would say gives quota spots, and that's X number of pretty much free entries to get in. Not free money-wise, but you don't have to pre-qualify. And then you have open registration, which is first come, first serve. And then you will have your best two of three scores that are kept to your overall ranking. Go ahead.
Can I just add?
Yes.
So if anybody wants to register for one of the participants, they should reach out to Winter, and then we can all pair up together. We can FaceTime on the phone while we're sitting there trying to get our kids registered.
Yeah.
And then also, if you're not sure about events, we do have our snow basin event on February 10th and 11th. So it's something to think about if your kids, you know, are on the edge of not wanting to compete, at least getting in their home environment just to try it out.
So it's a little less intimidating to compete at snow basin because they're familiar with the terrain, they know the mountain, they don't have to wake up at 5 a.m. to get the snowbird or park city or wherever.
My point is, we're here to help.
Yeah.
There's some of us in here for a while, and we're more than happy to
help you. I know. I know. I made it sound intimidating. Once we figure it out, just need to set a reminder on your phone to be on the computer next time. I'll make events in Team Snap of registration reminders. That will be helpful. Okay.
So, if you want to do the Snow Basin competition, you can do the IFSA membership as well. Okay.
Yeah. You have to pre-qualify, and then it's also 12 to 14, 15 to 18 age group.
Okay.
So, if you do compete and you feel, usually your coach will reach out if you think that your athlete's ready for it. Team Snap. You love Team Snap. have group messaging, we'll send emails and posts out. Our whole calendar year is going to be on Team Snap. We have two separate groups this year. We have an intro to free ride group and then a competition free ride group. If you are in the intro to free ride group and you want to compete, even in one of us, we'll have to meet the competition free ride group. So just let me know that, and a preseason questionnaire will help me a lot with that. You can start there, and then if you have questions, send me an email or give me a call. Stay current with your profile information. This is name, phone number, email, picture. Mark availability, RSVP. We need this 3 days before events so that we can have appropriate staffing. This was hard for free ride to do last year, so I need to be really on it. To RSVP all the events that you're planning to go to, it really helps us know who's showing up and how many coaches we need. Review the notes for the daily session. This is going to tell you what coaches are going to be there. Use team chat for only team-wide messaging. If you need to talk to just a few people specifically, you can make a separate chat. Or if you need to contact me or one of your other coaches, you can create a separate chat for that. Again, always have cell phone available in your athlete's profile so we can get in touch with you. Use the more option. So if you pull your phone out and go to the event or to our team Snap page, there's like the three dots and you can go there. And then there's a bunch of options. You can post photos there. And that also helps me. I run our social media, so I can post them there if you'd like. Also to share with other parents. And then we'll post documents in that same zone. So being able to navigate Team Snap is really important. That's what we use to talk to each other and communicate about our season. Do you have anything to add on that part?
Sorry, I was in a side conversation there, so excuse me if I duplicate in here, but where I see the biggest value in Team Snap is that you mark your availability. So is everybody comfortable with that? Because I understand that some Devo programs use, some Devo coaches used it pretty extensively within a group. Another Devo coach is to set up a personal text outside of Team Snap. The reason why we're driving all of our communication to Team Snap is so that we're in alignment with Safe Sport for youth and young athletes. That way, any communication that happens between the coach and your athlete is also copied to you as their adult. And also, it's something for this administrator, we can look back and look at those prior communications that took place. Okay. Where the other thing that I think was extremely helpful is that the team chat becomes team-wide information and not personal. We're running 10 minutes late communication. That 10 minutes late communication should go directly to your child's primary coach. In some cases, it's winter, but you're even better, you're more efficient with your communication if you know your child is going to ski with Ethan for the day, that you're communicating through Team Snap directly to Ethan. So to do that, within the chat, you just hit the plus, you find Ethan's name, select him, send him that direct message, he'll get that ping, he'll get back to you, and a lot of things happen that way. You also have the option just to hold it down and thumbs up. Do it that way, that it shows the coach that you've received that message, but yet it doesn't ping everybody in that group. Right? I just don't want to dilute the importance of that team communication to where you're overwhelmed or like, oh, that doesn't apply to me, that doesn't apply to me, when maybe it really does. We want to make sure that the value of communication is there, that you find it worthwhile. And then as Winter mentioned, the more category, it's very common in my experience with Team Snap that people will take a great picture and they'll put it in the chat, and then it gets lost in the chat throughout the year. But if you post it in the photos, which you would have to get to by clicking the three dots and going to more, then it will live within the team forever, and the coaches can go in and pull some of those photos out so that we can create nice little highlight videos at the end of as coaches, or pictures of our coaches interacting with your kids. Right? So if you see that kind of photo opportunity, please snag it, throw it up in the photos underneath your program, and that way we can utilize it as an organization. Okay? Thank you.
If you guys have questions about Team STEM, I'm helping. We have our speed sale this weekend. Thursday is member-only access. We're going to have a dry land session on Thursday as well in one of the grassy areas between the buildings. There's a lot of good deals with this sale, so if you need any equipment, this is really worth doing. And then on the 19th, so Thursday, we'll also have jacket pickup for your athletes. Okay. If you didn't hear that, first come, first serve, we may run out. This is just what we have. We're getting more jackets from our embroiderers.
So when does that early access start?
4 p.m.
4 to 6. We have a lot of stuff going on, like what you said. We have the jacket pickup. We get to be first look before the public gets to view. We have dry land going on, and we will also have our Toco representative there doing a waxing demo. So and explaining like the different waxes that are available. I just sent out an email today with their newsletter with a 40% off discount code for wax. So if you have questions about that, yes, they have. Thank you for reminding them. So Snow Basin will also have a resort person there that you can pick up, activate, and or get a refund for your athlete if you bought your season pass before you became part of the team. So that's a super, super huge benefit because they have not come to our team only event in the past. They've just been there on the public days and they can get pretty busy then. And to get your refund in person while you're standing there rather than sending it to the email and it coming probably in January is when it's most likely otherwise going to be, this is a pretty clutch opportunity for you to have that one-on-one interaction just for us.
I read something on the email that the team members, like there's early access to the equipment, but how do I know what to buy my kid?
That's so
probably a dumb question.
But. There are the people there that can help you. Yeah, and if you need recommendations, you can shoot me an email and I can send you some.
Okay.
Yeah.
And they have booths and skis and all of that.
Absolutely.
And you can try it all on.
You can get outfitted from head to toe. They have hats, goggles, helmets, jackets, pants, like socks, whole nine yards, and in addition to like the hard equipment of boots, skis, poles. All of that. And we'll have staff there and representatives from the companies that brought everything in. They can help you walk through sizing and fittings and all that kind of stuff.
And is it cash only or Venmo or?
We have credit card machines or debit cards.
Everything.
Any other questions? Would you welcome is a big fundraiser we do at the beginning of every year. This one's November 4th. If you want to buy tickets, it's linked on our website. You can also volunteer. Speaking of volunteering, your work deposit. You paid a work deposit when you registered. You can get this money back if you help us. We appreciate your money because we got to pay coaches and make the organization run, but we appreciate your time more if you're willing to come help and support at any of our events or with VNet install or VNet takedown. We really appreciate that. This is linked to our website. If you go to our website under volunteer page, you can submit your work deposit hours and you can also see our sign up genius to sign up for events, volunteering, and all of that. We have an Instagram, Facebook, tag us in your photos and videos, and then if you want us to share photos or videos, you can email them to media@snowbasinskiteam.org. You can also text them to me, because I run the social media. This is something I just wanted to put out there. It's a scholarship opportunity for 12-year-olds and up. They give you money, so if your kid wants scholarship opportunity, it's all based on Shane McConkie's core values. So he put together a list of core values, and your graphic will just kind of reflect on that and create a submission for the scholarship. It's a really cool program, so it's worth just looking into as well. Did you guys get it? We can go back to. And huge thanks to our sponsors, Atomic, Cody Button Ski Wrap, Right Lumber, UBS, Berkshire Hathaway, and... Yeah. I didn't know how to say it, sorry. Yeah, they support us a ton with everything, so we want to give them a huge shout. Any questions? This is all that we have for me. Go ahead. No, not necessary.
Oh.
Yeah. If you'd like it, but it's not necessary. We are only traveling inbounds. So all wears Ski Patrol mitigates. He snuck out. Yeah. He's our snow safety guy at Snow Basin. So he makes sure that we put our athletes on the safe mountain. Having said that, it doesn't mitigate all risk, so for traveling on the snowy mountains and there's a risk associated to that, so we do avalanche education, especially with Snow Basin being an open boundary policy. It's easy for people to sneak right out and move into terrain that's not mitigated. But while we're training together, we don't travel outside very often. So not necessary. Any other questions? Our gear handbook has recommended and required equipment and some links to websites that can help you find that sort of thing. If you need help, reach out to me, reach out to one of the other coaches. We're happy to support finding the right equipment for your athlete. Thanks for being here, guys. Appreciate it.
Just a few closing thoughts here. For our program, as we started off, there's a lot of the transition from the Devo program up. And with me being new to Freeride, I definitely have a strong desire to learn how athletes move through the pipeline and how they enter comps and how they license with IFSA. And I was paying attention to your body language. And there's a lot of you that feel as lost as I do. Is that fair to say? Okay. So there are a few of you in the room, and we're going to be leaning on you that have gone through the process. And like Carla, I know Carla stepped out, but we do have experts within our organization, Winter being the first and foremost of that. But what I'm foreseeing in the future is like the end of our Christmas break, that the coaches can send a little evaluation home as to what they're projecting for your athlete, what likelihood is it that they'll go to a competition. And if so, we'll have another quick little meeting, whether it's on Zoom or in person. Like, this is how you register with IFSA. This is how you register for a comp. This is the likelihood of getting into a comp. As I understand it, it's a first come, first serve. And if you're not on your computer as winter stressed, you're not getting in. And so that means we're certainly going to have an environment where some athletes get in and some don't. And so our program is going to be divided simply by that nature, where some athletes and coaches are off the comp, and some coaches and athletes are at home continuing their skill progression and hoping that they can get into the next comp. But again, it comes to that first come, first serve basis. Winter and I are going to go to the powers to be to try to create a system to where kids can get in automatically, and you don't have to necessarily fight for that spot. it, especially when it comes to their first home, that there's an avenue for them to build that excitement around free ride comps and keep things moving forward. So just rest assured that we can lean on each other and we'll help you through the process, because I need to learn myself.
It's not about that. It's how you feel about your line at the end of the day. So
that's what like we want for the athletes, is for them to be proud of themselves and you know, what they can accomplish. So, yeah. And I can think of one other story. Mercedes, were Mercedes' parents here? So this was another example that I think will apply to a lot of circumstances over the course of the winter. We were doing some practice over on the sisters on the Strawberry side of the resort, and had the whole group together, and I think Hudson, were you on? Yeah, I think that you were in the group that day. And we were all getting everyone together, hyping up, and Mercedes said something like, oh, Chase, I'm scared to do this, and I was like, okay, do it anyways. Going back to the whole point of, like, we're not going to put your kids in any circumstances if they're not ready for it. And said, just if you're scared, just do it scared. You'll be okay. And then sure enough, she went off this little drop, and she was just fine, and then completely ecstatic after the fact. So we're always going to be looking out for their best interest. So that's all I got.
Yeah, and in terms of expectations, like, for myself, I'm coming from a very competitive background with the rugby at Weber State, not doing Team USA stuff. You know, being a part of the basic career ride program, I want to create a presence of, you know, developing who we are. So when we pull up to a competition, when we pull up to the Woodward parking lot, I want people to know, like, oh, like basic free ride's here to throw down. And in terms of, you know, we're all about having fun, but when it's time to dial in, you got to dial in and do the work. So again, Chase and I and the other coaches, we want to develop your athletes in the sport, but you know, to be good members of society, if you could say. So that's kind of it for us.
Thanks, guys.
Last thing, we have T-shirts and hats. Every athlete gets a T-shirt and a hat all around these tables. You can pick them up. We'll want to let Tracy know, write down what size you got, what hat you got.
Just write your name down
so that we know that you've got a hat and a T-shirt for your athlete. Go ahead.
Can you explain a little bit about what, like, the table looks like? You know, from Vivo, your master of the team, you kind of coach.
Yeah.
Is it going to be different this way? We're coaching different people, or how's that work?
So, last year we had different groups pretty much every week and working with different coaches. This year we're going to kind of dial it in a little more, and your athletes are going to work with the same one or two coaches pretty much throughout the year and with the same group throughout the year. Day to day, we warm up, we'll start off doing a drill, kind of dial in some technique, work on that, and then we'll take that and do some focused skiing off piste. With that drill in mind and that technique that we're developing. We do mostly off-piste skiing. We're hardly ever on the groomers unless we're working on a drill or it's a fun spring day and we want to make some parking laps. But we also do endurance laps, so focusing on building endurance to ski top to bottom. We do a lot of trick practice, so we're going through the parks, practicing air awareness, practicing tricks if your athletes are ready for that. And then that's pretty much it. We do a cool down lap at the end of the day, and then a little chat about what we worked on, and then we'll
just
have
fun. Is it going to be like a Sunday or whatever, but it'll just be like a
week or 2 years? Oh, a holiday camp?
Yeah.
So that'll be a little different. Some days we'll have an activity in the afternoon. So last year we had avalanche education one afternoon where we went practice hard in the beacon and froze and dig, and then talked about where avalanches happen, how they happen, that sort of thing. Ethan did a tuning demo for us in here, so they'll learn how to box and feed their skis, sharpen their edges, make sure their bindings are adjusted properly, that sort of thing. So at least half days of skiing for a holiday camp, but can't hold full day skiing as well. Go ahead.
How are the groups set up? So you just set up by age or skill level?
Age and skill level. Yeah. So we'll kind of look at age first. So we want to be in age appropriate groups this year, and then skill kind of second. So if there's a younger athlete that's really excelling, maybe move them up to the more advanced.
How many kids are in your
So we have a 6-to-1 coach to athlete ratio. So it will be no more than 6.
That's the same as Evo.
No, you can come with me.
Number 6.
Ready to play.